أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لمقدمه الفداء على الله في كل الأمور توكلي وبالخمس أصحاب الكساء توسلي محمد المبعوث وابنيه بعده وفاطمة الزهراء والمرتضى علي. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah for another opportunity, inshallah that virtually we can get together and inshallah reflect on some of the divine words, revelation. I should remember in advance to thank Sister Rebecca for assisting us from Auslan for sign language. It's Tuesday evening, it's the time that normally we recite Dua Tawassul, and when better than the month of Sha'ban, and especially during this global challenge that humanity is put on facing an invisible enemy that is really attacking all of us, irrespectively. These days and recently I have been receiving a lot of questions, kind of philosophical questions, and perhaps as a result of misunderstanding of some of the Islamic principles. The question is the following. Even last night, even before I come, I received another email and I invited the brother to make sure that you join us on Facebook, YouTube, however possible, so that you can see and hear an elaborated answer. The argument is the following, that are we supposed to have faith in God and don't worry about following the hygienic rules in these days? Apart from, I'm not talking about the legal side of it, that you may be fined, you may even be, arrested. No, from the Islamic perspective, what is my duty? What does Islam say in this situation? Am I supposed to just follow the hygienic rules? I don't need to have faith in God, or faith in God is enough, I need to just trust in God and don't worry about the hygienic rules. God will look after you. Why do you panic? That's the argument that some people have. Unfortunately, both opinions are going to the two sides of the spectrum, that both of them are incorrect from the Islamic perspective. That's something that inshallah very briefly I want to prove and provide enough evidence from the Islamic perspective. See, tawakkul or trust in God is undoubtedly, indisputably one of the major principles in Islam. I believe in all religions, in all the divine religions, we are expected to have trust and only trust the Almighty God. In God alone we trust. That's what the Quran repeatedly says, and especially if you truly you know what the trust in God is and you trust God, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever, whosoever trust in God, God will suffice him. The Almighty God himself says that I love those who trust me, because trust in God is an application of faith, is the reflection of faith in God. And therefore God says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. God loves those who trust him. The Almighty God is commanding us, it's an obligation. If you want to remain faithful to God, you need to look at the bigger picture, as I will explain, and have your trust in God alone. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ. Those who know that as human beings, we need to lean on something. The only one that you can lean confidently is the Almighty God. And that's what that famous poet, I remember many years ago, I read it in one of the mystical books of Ibn Fanari, عَلَى اللَّهِ فِي كُلِّ الْأُمُورِ تَوَكُّلِي وَبِالْخَامْسِ أَصْحَابُ الْكِسَائِ تَوَسُّلِي. He says that in all my affairs, I put my trust in God. I always feel comfortable that my trust is in God, and also when it comes to resorting the means provided by God, I trust Ahlul Bayt, the noble family of the Prophet, that inshallah that will be the topic for, by the grace of God, for next week. So the paradox between faith in God, trust in God, or in today's situation of coronavirus, following the hygienic rules is that, my friend, look at the bigger picture. There is no paradox, there is no conflict, there is no contradiction between these two. As I will explain, these are not separated from each other. Following the hygienic rules, medical rules, in fact, is along with trust in God. When God says, trust in me, he means that trust in me through the means I provided. Hygienic rules are the means God says I provided for you. Therefore, yes, life and death is in the hand of God. God is the one who causes life and gives and takes life. Wallahu yuhyi wa yumeet. God is the one who causes causes life, gives life, and takes the life and causes death as well. However, as I will tell you, you need to look at the whole picture. The same God has made rules for birth to take place, has made rules for death to take place also as well. So remember then, what is the meaning of trust in God? The situation is the following, brothers and sisters. Normally, when we are facing a challenge, a serious challenge in our life, let's say that a financial turmoil, some brothers, some members of the community these days, they are losing their job and they feel down, okay? Someone gets sick and feels down. A lady was telling me yesterday that she has some symptoms of coronavirus and she started panicking. So when situations as such, financial turmoil, health turmoil and the like is affecting us, two things usually happen to us simultaneously. It affects our body, therefore we fall sick, for example, and some physical disorders, and at the same time it's affecting our mind and our souls, hence usually depression, anxiety, you name it, panic, fear of death, stress bombard us. Unfortunately, what it is that when mentally you are affected, it has negative impact on your body. Medically, it is proven that when you are panicking and you are stressed more, your immune system reduces. That makes that virus stronger against you. Now, trust in God, it means on the one hand, that you find a cure for your soul, for your mind, and that is trusting in God, that everything is in the hand of Almighty, all-knowing, all-wise, all-benevolent, all-merciful, compassionate God. Okay? God loves you more than your mom loves you. So God is going to look after you. Trust in God. Believe in Him and trust in Him. That calms you down. That helps to cure that panic, to cure that stress and anxiety. At the same time, trust in God aligns with the meaning of trust in God is that God that I worship and I believe as the creator, he has created cure for every ailment, as I will quote the references. So trust in God and following the hygienic rules, they are along with each other. Hygienic rules are the means provided by the Almighty God. Because I believe in God, I follow his order and I take the medication, for example, in this situation. While I take the medication, I trust in God and I know that it is God who has enabled this medicine to have positive effect on me. It is God who has made this property in, like for example, self-isolation to protect me against a pandemic. All right? God, the world, the order in the world could be in such a way that no matter what, you would be affected. No, God has made a law that, look, if you stay at home, self-isolate yourself, you will be protected. This means provided by God that I believe. This is the meaning of trusting God. It's not that I need to either follow the hygienic rules or have faith in God. They are together. They are not separated from each other. Now, from now, I provide the evidence to the rest of my time, inshallah, for you. Question, is it God who is the healer or medication, herbs? In the example that Quran gives, honey, for example. We have two ayah, two verses in the Quran. On the one hand, we see that Quran says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ We send down from the Quran which there is healing and mercy for the believers. So God is the healer. God is the merciful. And Quran heals. Okay? On the other hand, the same Quran speaking about the honeybee and the bee and the honey provided by the honeybee, Quran says, فِيهِ شِفَاءٌ لِلنَّاسِ In honey, there is healing for mankind. So question, God, excuse me, are you the healer or is the honey the healer? Do you see this paradoxical? God's answer is that no, there's no paradox, my dear. I heal through the honey. The final healer, the ultimate healer is me, but I do it through the means that I have created. That is, for example, honey. That is medication. That is self-isolation. You name the example. Another example from the Quran. To show this paradoxical so that we have a better understanding of our religion. Unfortunately, what we suffer often from is not our religion, is misunderstanding and misrepresentation of our religion. Question. Remember the person who was arguing earlier said that life and death is in the hand of God. All right. On the one hand, we have this ayat in the Quran. Allahu yatawaffal anfusa hina mawtaha. It is Allah, it is God who collects the souls at the time of their death. In other words, it is God who is causing death. All right. The same God in the Quran elsewhere says, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وَكِلَ بِكُمْ Tell them, it is the angel of death who is causing you and taking your soul. So question again is God causing death or the angel of death is causing death? God's answer is that why do you make it either or? It is not that they are together, it is God alone. But God manages the affairs of this world through the means he has provided. For the means of death, he has appointed angel of death. So angel of death is captured by the law and is through the law that God has introduced in this world for us. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, for that reason, while acknowledging that ayah that yes, God is giving life and is taking life at the time of death, he had a servant. His name is Anas. Over 10 years he was serving in the house of the Holy Prophet. Look at what he is narrating from the Prophet. He says, The Holy Messenger of God told me once, Ya Anas, أكثر من الطهور يزد الله في عمرك. Anas, make sure that, without getting obsessed, please don't get me wrong, I'm not talking about obsession, but within reasons, within what the medicine and the hygienic rules are concerned, the Prophet says that, make sure that you remain always, you purify yourself much. Make sure that you stay clean as much as possible. Okay, and purify yourself. يَزِدِ اللَّهُ فِي عُمْرِكَ God will expand the span of your life. Do you see? The Holy Prophet's understanding of the Quran is infallible. The Prophet is recommending his servant, you want your life be expanded? You want to live longer? Follow the hygienic rules. So it is God, remember, يَزِدِ اللَّهُ فِي عُمْرِكَ It is God who is expanding your life, but through the means provided. Beautiful. Now it's about the time to share with you a gem from the words, wisdom words of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. Again, please remember this. This hadith is also a principle. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam is quoted in an authentic hadith to have said, أَبَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يُجْرِ الْأَشْيَاءَ إِلَّا بِأَسْبَابِ فَجَعَلَ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ سَبَبًا The Almighty God refuses to manage, to run the affairs of this world unless through means. Means that He has provided. Means that He has introduced to us. And therefore, for everything, He has introduced a means. And then the Imam says, once upon a time, one of the prophets of the past fell sick. He refused to take any medication, herbal medication of that day. And he said, I'm waiting for God to heal me. His illness ailment prolonged until he was started getting worried. People were coming and said, Ya Rasulallah, don't you want to take any medication? He says, no, I'm not going to take any medication. I'm waiting for God to cure me. Until And unless when the situation was getting very, very dangerous, the Almighty God reveals to him, because it's God, where are you? God, I'm your prophet. I've been waiting for you to cure me. The Almighty God says, La ashfiq hatta tatadawa. That's the wording of the hadith. I am not going to heal you unless you take medication. Because you need to acknowledge that medication is also from me. Medication is also from, don't think that medication is separate from God. Medication is also from God. So to take medication, to take hygienic rules, you are putting your faith and trust in God because you are using means provided by God. I don't know if you've heard of the story, whether true or not, but the message is important. By the way, about the story of that prophet, don't think that how would a prophet do this? That's how the Almighty God has been training his prophets. Ar-Rahman allama al-Qur'an. The teachers and the mentors of the prophets is the Almighty God himself. There's a story, as I told you, whether true or not, but the moral of the story is very important, that once upon a time there was a flood, perhaps in, I don't know, in Queensland, wherever, and a guy was caught in his house. A boat came, passed by, and said, jump in, man, and said, no, thanks, I'm waiting for God to rescue me. After a while, flood is rising up. The guy had to go to the second floor of his house. Another, this time a motorboat, came, passed by, said, God, come on, jump in. And he says, no, thanks, I'm waiting for God to rescue me. Guess what? Eventually, the flood is rising up, and he had no choice but to resort to the top, the rooftop of his house. This time, a helicopter came, passed by, and they dropped the rope. Come on, grab the rope, we rescue. He said, no, thanks, I'm waiting for God to rescue me. Guess what happened? The guy drowned. And then in Barzakh, he was asking God, God, where were you? I've been waiting for you all the time to come and rescue me. God says, what else could I do for you, my foolish slave, my ignorant slave? Who do you think sent the first boat for you? Who do you think sent the second boat? Who do you think sent the helicopter? It was me coming to rescue you all the time through the means. And you ignore them one after the other. So there was nothing else I could do for you. And I, inshallah, conclude with this. I have still a little bit time. Okay, we can continue a bit more. There's much to say about this. In the series of practical Irfan, I have elaborated on this, but I will mention part of it, inshallah, here. A Bedouin came to the Holy Prophet and said, Ya Rasulallah, I came to see you. Knowing that he is coming from the desert, usually they were camelers. The Prophet says, what did you do to your camel? And the guy says, Ya Rasulallah, as if I'm coming to see the messenger of God, I just left my camel unattended. The Prophet said, you didn't shackle, you didn't hobble your camel? He said, no, I don't need to. Imagine somebody thinks that, okay, I'm going to the masjid or to the haram, why do I need to lock my car? Look at the answer of the Prophet. Famous hadith, the Prophet says, اَيْقِلْهَا وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Shackle, hobble your camel, wrap the knees of your camel. That's how they were locking their cars those days, I'm paraphrasing it. And then trust in God. And this is trust in God. So trust in God, my dear, is not that you are careless about hygienic rules. Trust in God is not that you don't go to work and you think that, okay, I'm sitting back because God is the provider, God provides. No, you have to work hard and trust in God that God is the provider. A Quranic example, as I told you, we have many examples to cite from Quran and the practice of Ahlul Bayt. In the story of Joseph, Prophet Yusuf, remember that when, long story short, when he's sending his sons back to Egypt to meet up again for the second time with Joseph, Prophet Yaqub, according to the teachings of the Quran, is giving them a recommendation. Ya Bani, La tadkhulu min babin wahid. My dear sons, don't go from one gate. Go from different gates when you are entering Egypt, when you're entering the city, Egypt, wherever it was. And then, yeah, this means that you are giving them the techniques, the tactics. This is utilizing the means like everyone else does. Then to assure them that this is not by itself protecting you, you need to use the means. And at the same time, the protector is God. He says, وَمَا أُغْنِيَ عَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. I cannot avail you against Allah at all. Okay, don't think that just by using the means, you don't need God. Because these means being effective or ineffective are in the hand of God. Yes, normally God's will is to make them effective. But at the same time, God is not obliged by his laws. Hence, often miracles happen. Hence, the property God has introduced to fire is to burn. In normal situations, fire burns. Yet God orders the fire that was set against Prophet Ibrahim not to burn, and did not. Okay? Knife, sharp knife, usually cuts especially human's flesh. Yet the Almighty God orders the knife that was in the hand of Prophet Ibrahim not to harm at all, not to scratch even the throat of little Ismail, his son. These are miracles and exceptional cases. Otherwise, in normal situations, we are bound to follow the rules and the laws and the means provided by the Almighty God, having faith in God at the same time that these are the means provided with God. This is the true meaning of inshallah, trust in God and faith in God. We are only a couple of days before the birth anniversary of our dear Imam, the 12th Imam, Imam Zaman and Jalallah Najwa Sharif. As I'm talking to you, there are requests to pray for the patients. A very dear friend of mine in Sweden, I was talking to him, hardly he could speak. Is affected by this COVID-19. May the Almighty God give quick recovery to him and all the patients. Also, just before I come to this session, I had a request from a couple of young ladies who are in labor. Please pray for their safe and easy delivery, inshallah. I will conclude, being the Tuesday evening night, with the last part of the Dua Tawassul, appealing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, resorting to God through his noblest, dearest, most beloved servant at the present time, and that is none other than Imam Zaman Ajjalallah Farajo Sharif. I say it, inshallah, on the breath. You can repeat with me, and with this we conclude. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. Ya wasiya al-Hasan wal-Khalafa al-Hujja. أيها القائم المنتظر المهدي يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا. Everybody. يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله. صلوات.